Welcome to the ATR 72500 flight gear video tutorial series. The ATR 72500 cargo and passenger variants are brought to you by the Omega Hangar. Please do check out our new website, theomegahangar.co.nr. Okay, now in this tutorial series, we'll be having videos focusing on the aircraft systems, such as the autopilot, the flight management computer, the manual startup procedure, and stuff. Okay, so let's get to this video. In this video, I'll be showing you how to program the FMC for a flight from Singapore to Kuala Lumpur. We'll be using a route and airway dat for airway format, so that's like the first time in flight gear. You can get routes in airway format from wataware.com or flightsimaviation.com, or even make up your own route with the mpmap.01.flightgear.org. So I've made up the route with MPMap for this one. Okay, let's get into the cockpit and start the video. Okay, as you notice, the aircraft doesn't have power. We can turn on the external power, or we could run in hotel mode. Hotel mode, you have to turn on any one of the two engines with propeller brake on. That's important. And then you turn on any of the AC wild generators to get power. That's gonna run your event. Let's just use external power for now. Make sure you turn on DC service and utility bus. Okay, so let's go to the FMC now. Right, so you turn on by clicking on PRT, and this is the ident page of the model engines. As you know, the company data is not installed yet. I haven't made it yet. I'll do it really soon. We do have nav data too, though if you don't have it installed already, please do get OmegaDAT 1.0 and position reference. Set your UTC times 10.18. Your GPS location, just make sure it's right. It would be enough to worry about that. Let's go to the route now. Okay, in the route page, now we have to enter our origin and whiskey maculaculator destination. Now you see the activate thing comes, we'll get back to you on that. Put in your runway, which is not compulsory, you could add it later. Flight number is Mike India Alpha 1634 from Singapore to Kuala Lumpur, and now the activate. You could activate the route now, but that would put the aircraft on a direct flight to Kuala Lumpur, and we don't want that. We want to put in the route legs. So, let's just go to the next page right now, where we put in the airways and the waypoint. So first, we're gonna fly to Bobag. When you put it in, it'll show direct, but we're gonna put in a sit-in later, so it's fine. Now from Bobag, we're gonna take the Papa 501 airway all the way up till Arama Alpha Romeo Alpha Mike Alpha. From there, we're going to take the Alpha 464 airway all the way up to Dumok, the Uniform Mike Oscar Kilo. So that's the basic airway format route. Now, we could activate, but I'm not. I'm going to go to the legs page right now to edit the legs. So you can see that there are more waypoints that you entered. That's because the route 1 legs actually takes out the waypoints from the airways and puts them in. Okay, so right now let's first activate the route. Before that, I want to show you that no changes have been made to the flight plan yet. Now, when you activate it, you have to execute the changes. Now, this is important about the ATR-72FMC. When you make a change, they don't go in unless you activate them. Once you activate them, you see that the change is there. So you have to actually execute all the changes so that it goes into the active route. See the map. We have the whole flight plan, the map too. Now, just for an example in how to edit, I'm gonna show you. Let's say we wanna go to PMOC and then Arama instead of ANBUS. So you first type in PMOC and insert it right above ANBUS. That's where you want it to be. And you see it says mod there, that the active route has been modified, and you have to execute the changes again. Now let's remove ANBUS. Select down Arama. You can select away from it, click on it, and then move it up. There we go. And execute our changes. If you check the map, we should have it on our new. Our changes should be on the active route. So that's that. Let's get back to ANBUS because I want to follow the actual route, which is Papa 501. Sorry, ANBUS. And remove PMOC. And said no changes have been executed. When I click on execute, it puts in the changes for the route. Okay, and the right side, now this is for altitude constraints. They display on the ADU. They're not actually VNAV, they just tell it, like, gives you a warning or an advisory if you're going there. Now to add a waypoint, you could just type it in and then click on the LSK next to then. Okay, that's about it here. Let's go performance init. First I'm going to set in 2.0 blocks of reserve fuel, 18,000 feet of transition altitude, and we'll be cruising at flight level 140, not a really long flight. Make sure you do type in FL and execute. Now, okay, if you don't execute, you could also erase it. There for legs to, once you erase it, it goes back to what was saved. I'm going to put in flight level 140 and execute it. You can automatically load gross weight and fuel. There's some small error there. I'm going to fix that soon. And you have prime cruise, cruise descent performances. That's like your speed and IES and Mach. So I'm going to go 180 knots and 0.55 Mach. You could put the M if you want, doesn't matter, and the fuel configuration is not necessary. Then 250, 0.55 for descent. You don't have to put an M, but I'm going to put it anyway. Now once you're done with that, you go to the next page to get your descent calculations. Your top up descent at flight level 140 is 55 miles off. You need to descend at negative 1200 feet per minute, but it also calculates your required VS at the last waypoint. So if you see here, the top up descent around there and towpor is there, so you don't have to watch your DME. You could go to towpor and start your descent at negative 1000 feet per minute. As simple as that. Let's go select our SID and STAR now. First departure, there are runways here. If you select change runways, your SID option changes. We're gonna stick to 20 right. Select the debug 1F, that takes us to Bobag. And let's, oh wait, execute our execute it, and there we go. The SID is put onto the active route, so now we're gonna fly the SID and then go into the actual flight plan. You see that it's also there in your ND, so you can keep an eye on it without opening the map. Okay, so now let's go back to departure arrival and go to arrival at Kuala Lumpur. Select runway 14 left. It's supposed to be La Pear. Strange. Oh wait, sorry, that's a wrong runway. It's 32 left. Okay, there we go. There's La Pear. So that's used. We're gonna use the La Pear star. Just click on it again if the execute light's not already on. Yeah. Now you have Nipar Sasri if you're coming in from the east or south. And then we have La Pear, which would be. La Pear would be perfect for from where we're coming in. It's like a straight in entry. Let's execute our changes. There we go. The thing, it's not really necessary, but whatever star you're using, it puts us right on track for the ILS or for a visual straight in approach. So there, and you should also see that the airport and the runway would be mentioned in the active route one legs area. Okay, so now we're also going to be making another route, route 2, that's like your alternate route, or, you know, like a route you can fly later. Let's go to progress now. There's a small error here with the label and the fuel value. I'm going to fix that as soon as possible and upload it. And this shows you your last waypoint, the waypoint you're going to. Your altitude, or I mean not altitude, distance to go, and then the ETA in Zulu. Zulu time is what we put in the position reference. It'd be taking that as your initial, that's your current time. Well, that's all for now. Thank you for